Hey everybody, welcome to the Family Fudge and welcome to Croctober. In today's video, I'm sharing four super cozy crockpot dinners that are perfect for fall. And you guys, these recipes are some of my family's all-time favorites. They are all budget-friendly and they are all pretty much dump and go, which makes them super quick and easy to put together. Okay friends, I'm kicking things off by making some easy crockpot chicken and dumplings. Now, I really think that chicken and dumplings are the ultimate comfort food. To my slow cooker or crock pot, I'm going to start by adding 2 cans of cream of chicken soup. Of course, this is going to make our dish nice and creamy. And then to this, I'm also going to add 1 can of chicken broth. Then I'm going to whisk it all together until there are no more lumps. At this point, I'm ready to add 1 chopped onion, and then I'm also gonna be adding in some chopped celery and carrots. Now, to season this up, I'm also adding in 1/2 teaspoon of poultry seasoning, and this is actually Southern style poultry seasoning, but any kind will do. Next, I'm adding 1 teaspoon of garlic, about 1/2 teaspoon of pepper, and now I'm going to mix this all together until combined. And now it's time to add the chicken. Now I'm using boneless, skinless chicken thighs because I really prefer dark meat in this, but you definitely could use chicken breast if that's what you prefer. And I really just want to get these chicken pieces completely submerged in this delicious mixture. Now at this point, I'm going to go ahead and get my lid on, and I'm going to cook this on low for 4 hours, and then I can do the next step. And check it out, you guys. This smells amazing. The chicken is cooked all the way through, and it is so nice and tender. And I'm going to shred this right in the crock pot. I don't even have to take it out. But we can't forget about the dumplings part. Now, I'm definitely taking some help from the store with these dumplings, and that's because I'm using some refrigerated canned biscuit dough. Now, how many dumplings you add is up to you. You could add 1 can of biscuits or 2. I'm just gonna go ahead and flatten mine out just a bit, and then I'm going to cut them. If you have the really jumbo-sized biscuits, you're gonna wanna cut those a little bit more because you're looking for about bite-sized pieces. So now I'm going to scatter these biscuit pieces all over the top, and then I'm gonna get my lid back on because this needs to cook for at least 1 more hour or until the dough is cooked through. Okay guys, next up is a recipe that I like to call crockpot hobo casserole. First, I'm gonna go ahead and brown up 1 pound of ground beef. And you guys, that's one thing I love about this recipe is you only need a little bit of meat. I know meat can be pretty pricey right now, so this is a great recipe if you're trying to stretch your budget. Oh yes, and I am gonna go ahead and drain the grease from this ground beef. Next, I'm gonna go ahead and slice up my potatoes. I already gave these a nice scrub, so they're very clean, and I'm gonna go ahead and leave the skins on. So now I added these potatoes to my crock pot, which I already sprayed with nonstick spray. And then to this, I'm gonna go ahead and add 1 can of kidney beans. Now I did go ahead and drain these, and then I'm also going to add a can of diced tomatoes, and I didn't drain these. I like the tomatoes and their juice in here. Next, I'm adding some diced onions, followed by some salt, oregano, garlic, and then to make this nice and creamy, I'm adding 1 can of cream of mushroom. Now, if you don't like cream of mushroom, you can definitely swap this out for cream of chicken or cream of celery. And lastly, the ground beef. Now, at this point, I'm gonna need to use my muscles because I need to stir this all together. Now I'm going to add my lid. You could cook this on low for 8 hours, but I'm gonna cook mine on high for just 4 hours. Now when the time is up, I'm going to remove the lid, and I'm going to sprinkle about 1 cup of shredded cheddar cheese directly on top. Then I'm going to pop the lid back on just until the cheese is melted. The This next recipe is what I like to call Olive Garden chicken, and it's one of the easiest crockpot dinners that you can make. To my crockpot, I'm going to start by adding about 2 pounds of boneless, skinless chicken thighs, and next comes the Olive Garden part. I'm using 2 cups, or this entire bottle, of Olive Garden Italian dressing. That's right, I'm putting salad dressing in here, but trust me, you guys, this one is really good. Next, I'm adding in about 1/4 cup of shredded Parmesan cheese, and I am gonna save some of this cheese to add to the top of the dish before I serve it. And then I'm also going to add 1 brick of cream cheese. I'm just going to plop this right in here. Now you guys, this one cooks super fast. It only takes about 5 to 6 hours on low or about 4 hours on high. Now, once this chicken is done, you should be able to shred it up really easily. I like to shred this directly into the crock pot. And at this point, you could add this to a sandwich roll. You could serve it on top of mashed potatoes, but I really like to serve it with noodles or pasta. So I've cooked about 1 pound of farfalle pasta, and I'm going to add it directly in here and mix it all up. Okay guys, now that brings me to another really easy recipe that is kid friendly. I'm gonna be making cheesy crockpot chicken and rice. To my slow cooker, I'm going to add about 1.5 to 2 pounds of chicken tenders. I'm using chicken tenders because that's what I have, but you definitely could use whole chicken breast or even chicken thighs. And now I'm really going to season up this chicken. First, I'm adding 1 teaspoon of garlic salt, 1 teaspoon of onion powder, about 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper, and then 1/2 teaspoon of paprika, or as my grandma used to say, paprika. So now I'm gonna go ahead and toss the chicken around in all of these seasonings and spices. Now at this point, I'm ready to add 1 chopped onion, some minced garlic, 2 cups of chicken stock or chicken broth, and then I'm adding 1 can of cream of chicken soup and 1 can of cream of mushroom soup. And you guys, that's all I'm going to do at this point. I'm not putting the rice in here yet. All I'm gonna do now is cover this. You could cook this on low for about 5 to 6 hours, but I'm gonna cook mine on high for about 3 to 4 hours. And you guys, the trick here is that when there's about 30 minutes left of cooking time, that's when I cook my rice. So once that rice is done, I can go ahead and add it into my crock pot. And then I actually have 2 different kinds of cheeses. I have cubed cheese and shredded cheese. I'm gonna go ahead and add in the cubes of cheese at this point, and then I'm going to stir it up. So I'm going to mix these in here like that, and then with the shredded cheese, I'm just going to put that on top. Now I'm gonna pop my lid back on for about 5 more minutes or until the cheese on top is melted. Okay guys, now I hope this video inspires you to get out your crock pot and make something cozy for fall. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe if you're new. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.